No place else I could store it. Hey, Arthur, give me a hand. You want the money or not? Come on. Arthur, we need to find the money, get the hell out of here.
Let's go. Thank you. I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Yeah. You take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
Time to go, boy. What you preparing for?
The greatest of gifts.
An unguarded stagecoach.
No, you simple-minded fool. Bison.
Bison?
Bison, from which you can get anything. There's some over on the plains, I believe. I saw a couple a long way off.
Oh. Good luck.
You want to come with me? I'll show you how we hunt one.
Sure. Why not?
Mount up then. Let's go.
Come on, pal.
You know, it was before my time, of course, but my mother used to tell me stories of how her tribe moved with the bison. They lived almost as one. Where the bison went, my people went. And they were the center of all life. We couldn't survive without them. They provided us with everything. Food, clothing, shelter, tools. There was a lot of respect.
Huh. I don't remember much of my childhood, but I think my people, we pretty much moved with the whiskey.
Well, my father did that too. Let's try over here, to the left. Over there. You see them all? Incredible, aren't they? We should only kill one of them. I'll keep them ringed in and you see if you can bring one down. Okay? Clean as you can.
Okay.
Job. Stow that on your horse and mount up. I wanna go check something out.
Okay, let's go. Where are we going?
I thought I saw some scavenger birds over here. Just wanted to see what attracted them. Left for dead, it looks like.
Why would someone do that?
I don't know. But I see tracks heading in this direction. I say we follow them.
All right. Lead the way.
Okay.
Could it have been an animal?
No, they've been shot. I just don't know why anybody would just leave them here to rot like that. Look, another dead bison. On the hill to the right. Come on. Shot and left for dead again. But this one looks fresher.
There's a camp there. I'm gonna take a look. Haven't gone cold yet. Maybe half a day since they left.
Bison's been dead about the same amount of time.
So what do you want to do?
They could still be in the area. Let's get up higher. See if we spot anything. This way. We should have a good view from up here. See anything? Arthur, look. Smoke to the north. Could be another camp.
Let's go check it out.
Bastards. Just killing for fun.
Think we can talk?
I don't kill for fun. I kill when I need to. Did you fools shoot those bison?
What's your problem?
I said, did you fools shoot those bison?
Calm down, you black or red bastard, whatever the fuck you are.
Did you shoot them?
Yes, we did. We shot them bison, we'll shoot you too if you don't get...
What business is it of yours? What? Wait...
It's that business of mine!
Good God, you're crazy! Look, I got a family. A family. Don't shoot me!
Stand back, Charles. I'll get you some answers.
What the hell are you doing?
Why are you killing those bison and leaving them to rot?
I don't know what you're talking about!
God damn it, tell us or you're dead!
Oh, okay. We were paid to kill as many as we could and make it look like it was Indians.
Just kill him, Arthur.
No! Please! Don't kill me! I'm begging you!
I've heard enough.
Damn right. That's what he deserved. I've seen enough of this. I'm heading back.
Okay. I'm gonna see if there's anything worth taking from their camp. I'll catch up with you later.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
How you think I'm doing?
I'm sorry. Just let me know if there's anything I can do. Anyway, I won't disturb you.
Okay, then.
Hey, Sean.
New pistol.
Have an arrest there, eh?
And boy, have I earned it.
Well, don't get too comfortable.
Sure.
My leg's all numb. Please hurry. Oh, yes. Yes, just lift as hard as you can. Oh, thank you. Thank you,
sure.
You saved me. Oh,
okay.
That was bad.
Sure.
I could have been stuck here and starved or eaten. Oh, you poor, dumb animal. Oh. What'll I tell Mildred? Well, thank you.
You need a ride home, ma'am?
Oh, yes, mister, please. Thank you. Do you know Valentine? I live there.
No problem. Yep.
I don't normally travel this far alone, you know. I was off inquiring about a possible new line of work. I'd borrowed a friend's horse for the trip. See, my husband... Well, it's just me and my boy now, and it's hard to find work.
I'm sure it is. Yeah.
A good opportunity. That's what I'm looking for. Not much work for a woman with a boy to raise. I won't work in no saloon, but I've got sharp eyes and quick hands. I was hoping to get a job working as a seamstress. A wealthy man said he'd pay me for the work.
Sounds promising. Also doesn't sound real.
Oh, you may be right, I suppose. He said he'd provide room and board for me and for my child. He wanted to meet me first.
I'd be careful with offers like that, ma'am.
I can't afford to dismiss offers like these, even if they do seem... odd.
Just be careful is all I'm saying.
I may not have another opportunity like this. Now I'll have to pay Mildred back for her horse.
It sure sounds like you're in a hard position.
You finding me is the only good thing that's happened to me in a long while, sir. Close now. Just a little further.
I'll sleep well tonight.
We're here. Thank you for all your help. You're a good man.
Glad I was able to help. You take care. Appreciate it. You be well.